Greetings, hockey fans, and welcome to Game 2 of my season of NHL 93 Origins. Tonight we have the Toronto Maple Leafs versus the Montreal Canadiens, and I will be playing the Montreal Canadiens. And just to clear up any misunderstandings, I'm not always playing for the home team. I'm actually flipping a coin before every game to decide who I play. It just so happens that this game and the previous game, I flipped heads both times, which means I'm playing the home team both times. Tonight's goaltending matchup, we have Felix Potvin of the Toronto Maple Leafs. He's going head-to-head against Patrick Waugh of the Montreal Canadiens. The best players on each team, we have Gary Lehman, Vincent Danfous, and Al Iafrady on the Maple Leafs, all rated 81. On the Montreal Canadiens, we have Stéphane Richer, rated 80, and Chris Chelios, rated 86. So those are the key guys in this game. Also of note, on Toronto, we have Randy Carlyle on defense. This was before his Norris Trophy winning season with the Pittsburgh Penguins. His rating is actually quite low. He's a spare defenseman for the Leafs in this. But without further ado, I'm just going to go ahead and get to the gameplay. And we have Chelios here now with the puck. He's been passed up the sideboard. There's Stéphane Richer, the other key player I said there from Montreal. He's knocked down by Gary Lehman, one of the Leafs' few stars in this. The Leafs have a fairly weak team on the back end. They have a good top line, but after that it gets a little sparse. Montreal's pretty much the same, but not quite as bad. And oh, I have a goal already. Keep active from Stéphane Richer and Shane Forsen. Again, we have another centerman scoring. I said I was going to try and cut down on that, but I couldn't resist that shot right there. It was just way too easy. So Potvin has been beat. It's now 1-0 for Montreal. Gary Lehman with the puck again. Looks like they kept the top line out there. I didn't notice. And here we go with Matthew Schneider. I did not mean to do that. Tried to do a speed burst and instantly roofed it. Guy Carbonneau taking the faceoff there. They still got the top line out. Jeez, I've now gone through all three of my scoring lines and they still have the top line out. There's number 41 is Brent Gilchrist from Montreal. Of course, he had a really good year in, I think it was 91-92. He had 50 points. Reason why he made the regular lineup here in Montreal. And on the Toronto Maple Leafs, it's going to be a little bit confusing when I'm trying to do any kind of commentary, because they have some numbers repeated multiple times. Gary Lehman scores. Okay. I think Waugh put that in his own net. Great. But as I was saying, there's a lot of numbers that have doubled up on Toronto. We have three number 32s, we have a couple number 23s, and it is going to get a little bit confusing with the play-by-play. And number 8 is... Oh, that's Matthew Schneider. 28 earlier was Eric Desjardins. Here we have Matt Schneider. He couldn't break in. And the top line out there again. Looks like they've got their top line. Those Ally of 3 up to Gary Lehman. I think everybody switched their lines. It's Chris Chelios. Over to the side, Stéphane Richer. Out front, I think it was Chelios took the shot, and Potvin saved, Mironov, that's Forsen, Richer, and Schneider misses, Forsen again, Patrick Waugh picks up behind the net, side, Richer, knocked down by Potvin. Forsen, back to the point, picked off by Dan Marowal, one of the number 32s. There's three of them in this game. And I'm getting a penalty. Chelios scoring. Okay, that's fine. That's his first penalty of the season. And here, look at the Montreal Canadiens penalty kill unit with Ryan Skruglin taking the face off. And there's Mike McPhee. These guys only see time on the penalty kill. And Skruglin with a goal. Again, another centerman with a goal. Unit out, and this time we have, who is this? Oh, that's Mark Hunter, and I think the other guy is, yes, Gilbert Dion. And they're getting a penalty now. That's good. Who is it? 9, Russ Courtney. He's on the second line here for Toronto in this game, as well as the second power play unit. And a little bit of 4-on-4 here. Stéphane Lebeau to take the face off. And wins it over to the side. Mike Keane, of course, had a big 60-point season in 1993. Why he's here on the second line. It's his only good offensive season. And it was mainly because of assists. We have Vincent Danfous. They've got their... I can't be Vincent. Yeah, it is Vance. It's Vance. So you have the top line up there again. Tom Kervers on the second line. He had started his career with Montreal, of course, part of the infamous trade that between Toronto and New Jersey that essentially sent Scott Niedermayer to the Devils. Oops. But in this game, he is a member of the Montreal Canadiens. He finished his career in Japan, actually, back in 94-95. There's John Appert out front. Carbonell stopped by Pop Van. Of course, Brant Gilchrist, the other member of that third checking unit, wasn't out there with the 4-on-4. Brief power play time here for Montreal. Now we have Mike Keane with the puck again. Tried to get in front of LeBeau, didn't work. Inside and 32. That's closing in. Oop, taken down. Portnoy in front, stopped, picked up by, who's that, Scott Pearson. Yes, Scott Pearson's on the penalty kill, and that number 9 is actually Stu Gaven. It's his only time on the penalty kill. It wasn't Russ Portnoy. Another number there for Toronto that's unfortunately doubling up, and it's going to cause me some confusion as I play through the season. 18 is Kent Mandeville. Patrick Waugh. I can't seem to hit these guys. There we go. The goal tab. Patrick Waugh took a note for me. Awesome. It's a good thing goaltenders can do whatever in the hell they want in this game. Didn't make it work. Almost out of time. Alright, so it's 2-1 after 1. The second period. Top line's out there again. I think Toronto's top line spent most of that first period on the ice. Forsen out front. Atkins couldn't get it. Trichet stopped. Coming back to Vincent Danfus. Shot stopped by Patrick Waugh, and I just give it right back to Gary Lehman, who already has one goal already. Chelios intercepted by Danfus. They're getting a penalty. I'll take it back down. And out front, Richey. I couldn't get the shot off quick enough. I don't know why, but for some reason they made me hold on to the puck there. But that's fine. I'm going to get a power play now. Second unit with Stefan LeBeau is out there. Inside. Montreal is one of the few teams in here that actually have extra defensemen. Instead of having 8, they've got 10. So on the power play, they have their forwards, their 6 regular forwards, which for most teams they would have a spare. Toronto has a couple spares on the power play. It's the only time that they see any ice time is when there's power play. Montreal is different. They have 10 defensemen, so all the forwards on the power play are their top two lines. Of course, that was the same for defensemen, but that's the same on every team. And I think I'm getting a penalty now. Who is it? It's charging. Tom Kervis, the defenseman. I don't know where that happened. So we're back to 4-on-4, and they once again got that top line out there. They love that top line. Well, why not? I mean, Lehman's already scored one goal, and he's had another chance as well, so I guess it's justified to have that unit out there as much as possible. And they're going to get a two-man advantage. This isn't good. Matt Schneider, I have 2 of my defensemen on as well. But that doesn't matter as much because the 2 penalty kill units, all of the defensemen are out there to kill the penalties. The spare defensemen, I mean. So my regular defensemen are not on the ice. They will not be on the ice to kill the penalty. And this one in here in particular, I have Breezeblom and Ludwig. There's another thing I've noticed on the penalty kill as part of the, one of the reasons why I actually like the Genesis version here now much more than the Nintendo version. The defensemen are not pinching. They are playing like defensemen on a penalty kill. You know, in NHL 94, they would come up a little bit, but not in this one. They are staying back, as they should, because they're killing a penalty and they are defensemen. It's part of the, what seems to me, the advanced AI in the Genesis version of the game. And this will take care of their brief power play. Dmitry Mironov is gone. A couple seconds, I'll have myself a power play. But for now, I'm going to get that checking line out there again. Once again, it's minus Frank Gilchrist because the right winger is not going to be out here. And they've got the top line out there again. It's Vincent Danfus and Lehman. Guy Carbonneau. He's one of Montreal's, one of the NHL's all-time best defensive forwards, and he gets over to Schneider. Schneider is in the right wing, and he came out of the box, and he gets himself a power play goal. So he's the first defenseman to score so far in the season. Matt Schneider's first on the power play. Richet. Corson stopped. Corson. Acton stopped. Ifrady to Courtnell. So he's the second unit out here. Oh my. Keen with it again. Matt Schneider. Goal scorer. Latest goal scorer. Stefan Richet out front. Stopped. Rebound. Oh, Corson was behind him, but he couldn't get the shot off. Knocked down the pot then. And they've got their top line out there again. They use that top line so much. And I know I said that once you get off the top line for Toronto, the quality of players go down, but not that much. I mean, until you get to the spare players, Montreal and Toronto are actually fairly equal. It's when you get to the spare parts that Montreal has a huge advantage. And of course, Montreal also has a huge advantage on defense. And here's an injury, so it's going to be the first 5-minute penalty. It's going to be Stephen Lebeau. So it's saying two. He's going to go to the box for two. But because there are no 5-minute penalties in this game, I am going to assign him a 5-minute penalty on the website. And get to see that second. I should probably should have put the first penalty kill unit, because this one's been out already. I don't think the first one's been out yet. And Skruber has two goals now. It's a good thing he's a spare part. He now has two goals, McPhee and Ludwig with the assist. That's Ludwig's first point. McPhee, of course, set up the first goal. And Gilbert Dion. Oh, this line was out before. Yeah, I remember because I actually scored with Skruden before. So I got this unit out right afterwards. I remember. And it's Chelios. I think it was Chelios anyway. No, that was Lyle Odeline. That's right. Fun little fact about Lyle Odeline. He played for Montreal and wore number 24, which was, of course, Chris Chelios' number, so they're both wearing 24 here. When he went to Chicago, he wore number 7, which, of course, was Chris Chelios' number in Chicago as well. So it was, was there another team? No, those were the only two. So it was kind of a bit of a joke, actually, that he was following around and taking his number after he left. But, of course, Chelios was around an awful lot longer than Odeline, so he never got the chance to do it in Detroit. And there's another 5-minute penalty. I believe that's Chris Chelios, unless I was still on the penalty kill. Who is it? No, it's Lyle Odeline. I was still on the penalty kill, and I'm going back on it again. Lyle Odeline has gone for 2 minutes, which is really 5, because he injured Stu Gaby. And there's Skruglund. I wonder if he can get the hat trick. I am not going to try and get him the hat trick. He's a centerman. He's already got two goals. Let's let somebody else get a goal. Somebody. Anybody. No more Skruglund. Will this guy let me go? Fuck. And Brisebois. Brisebois behind the net. Over to McPhee. McPhee. Back to the point. Oh, he tried to get back to Craig Ludwig. Ludwig, of course, not known for his shooting ability. Very defensive defenseman. Rookie season, he didn't even score a goal, and that was the second season, which was also 25 points, were the seasons that I was judging by for his rating, and those were his two best offensive seasons, and in the first one, he didn't even score a goal, so that should tell you right there how good of a shot he had, how much emphasis he placed on his shot. O-line, trying to pass that front, didn't work. Ludwig, blocked. They'll be doing a lot of that soon. And there's another 5-minute penalty. Mike Eastwood is gone. And the penalty's going to go to Patrice Brisebois, number 43. So I'm back on the penalty kill again. But I kind of hate that. Because it's the same two lines now. I almost don't want to score. Because if I keep scoring goals now, it's going to be the spare parts of getting all the points. And that's just not realistic at all. So I hate it when there's a string of penalties like that. I don't want to, it's not that I don't want these guys to score, because I do, I want everyone to score, but Strulin's already got two goals this game. And unless these guys are out for the full 2 minutes, and he's going to get another chance to score. And I think that's just a bit too much, especially the first game of the season. Brian Skoglund already had 2 goals. And it was Gilbert Dion. I chose Leclair over him on the third line when I made the line combinations. And even though Dion had a better rating by one mark, but still he did have a better rating. And out of the box again, Yurke Lume, number 20, is 2 number 20s for Montreal. The other one's a forward, Mark Hunter, on the other penalty kill unit. There's Lyle Odeline again. I don't know who he is now. Penalty kill unit out there. Oh, I tried to pass there. Oh, no, Mark Hunter's on this unit. So we have the 2 number 20s for Montreal on the same penalty kill unit. One's a defenseman, and the other right there is the centerman. So that's not confusing at all. Ha! Wait till you see Hartford. Hartford's top defensive pair, both from wear number 5. With Markel and Ulf Samuelsson. That's going to be confusing, because they don't even differentiate in this game. I mean, they have the position showing up there as number 43, a right wing, because he just came out of the penalty box. When the defensemen come up, it just says defenseman, like that. So you have 5 defensemen, 5 defensemen. I'm not going to be able to tell them apart on the ice, obviously. It's not possible. So unless they score, I have no clue which one I'm controlling. There's Hunter with the save. Try to get it. Yes, face off. Perfect. We need to get these guys off the ice. That top line out there again. See if one of these guys can get a second point. I don't want Sprudlin to be my top scorer for this game. Being spare part that he is. As much as I love the guy, I mean, he's a great player, especially on defense, but I'd like to see if he was actually in the lineup, be a leading scorer for this team. Not someone on the penalty kill unit. Acton tied up over Leonard Clark. Second unit out here now. Ooh, Marois stopped to Forsen. Forsen intercepted by Marois. And the shot stopped by Waugh. Schneider, Chelios up to Richet. Richet over to Forsen, stopped. And Pockbans picked it up. Up to Danfoos and down to Lehman into the corner. It's icing picked up by Matt Schneider. Second unit out here now. They've got the first unit out again, and I was an idiot, and then Desjardins dumped all the way down into my zone. At the end of the boat, up the side, no time, Keane shoots it, and the game is over. It's 4-1 Montreal. It was a rough game, lots of 5-minute penalties. So, I'd like to say thank you for tuning in, and hope you tune in next time when we have the Detroit Red Wings playing against the Chicago Blackhawks. Until then, 4-1 Montreal. Have a good night.